Greetings all, the Devious Monkey here. Today, another quickie. I ordered some more stuff for just the whole setup in general of what I'm planning on doing in the future, which is more outdoorsy, activey type things. So you gotta have the right stuff to do that so that it's done not crappily. That being said, what I've had is one of these GoPro clamps that can, you know, basically clamp off to handlebars or a desk or whatever it may be. It has that gorilla potty type movement and action to it. So yeah, I'll never get that straight again. Giggity. I've had this for years and it has just been clipped off to my shelves over there or various desks or whatever. And I've just never used it because I never really had much of a use for it, because I'm a big lazy chode and I haven't ridden my bike in a long time. But I plan on riding my bike a lot more. In fact, as soon as it gets a little bit warmer out, I know, lame excuse, especially when I see the group of old women riding their bikes every damn day and a big like biker gang of like 6 or 7 people. Anyways, yeah, I'm gonna start riding my bike more and I thought this would be perfect. Now, the nice thing about this is that one, I already had it, and two, it is like these clamps, man, they are really, like, you got to use two hands to effectively get that open. So I'm confident that one, and oh, it's got all like this really nice like grooved rubber on the insides and it really holds well and it doesn't slide. I have tested that before. So it's got the connector that takes one of these GoPro type fittings that slides in there and locks in there. Now it snaps in there. I went to Amazon and I got this bag of fittings from Neewer, and it has the small, and I don't think these are ever going to come into focus, but it's like a small low one and then the one that has the higher sort of like curved up raised piece. So your typical GoPro fitting, and it just slides down in the little grooves there and then you just tighten it off. Now, because I have all of these things here for my GoPro and my Insta360 1R, so now it can just clip off to like the handlebars and it should stay on there. Piece of cake, right? That's all coming. Again, sorry, but I'm not riding around in the cold and the rain and so on and so forth. So I have another video planned where I'm gonna show you the disgusting mess that's in my garage of the 50 billion boxes from all the Christmas gifts and all the packages that I get that I gotta get rid of. And then I'm gonna dig my bike out and I have to get that all ready to go to be able to ride it around and all that stuff, blah, blah, blah. I'll be doing some time lapses and showing you how all that goes together. But I just wanted to show you how, you know, again, I have all this equipment that's just laying around that's come full circle that I'm gonna start using again. So here you go. This will come in handy. And I also, even though I said I wasn't gonna use it, I thought, okay, I took the Insta360 1R and I redid the firmware to the newest firmware so that everything's a little bit easier to use, but it's just gonna have shitty audio. In fact, I probably won't hook up external audio to it. I'm just gonna use the internal mic and that should be fine. And if it isn't fine, then I'll just turn the audio off and put some music on and you can watch that. Okay, quick video. Again, I'm gonna start doing a lot of these quick type videos. They're gonna be under 5 minutes. I'm gonna whip right through them, not blather on, just so that I can crank them out and get you the information that you need. I don't even know if this is even made anymore. If it is, I'll link it in the description. I will definitely link this bag of fittings and all that kind of stuff in the description, and you can go out and buy it for yourself. That's all I've got for you today. As always, thanks for joining me. Like, subscribe, and all that shit. And remember, kids, forward and up.